Get your SISM training from Thor Peterson.
In this lecture, we will talk about what happens after we do a risk assessment and a risk identification. We have presented our results to senior management with our recommendations. Now they choose what we do. And the only acceptable choices here: mitigation, transference, acceptance, or avoidance. And as the image over here on the right indicates, in this phase, we're doing response and mitigation. This is where we might choose not to issue laptops, or we don't build that data center in an area that is prone to flooding. And we do this in very, very close collaboration with the risk owners and the people who own the systems that we are securing. We might have staff that are going out and doing remote sales, or we might have engineers in the field. Well then, in that case, not issuing laptops is probably not an option. Here, we might choose to do what we talked about in the previous lecture, where we talked about qualitative and quantitative risk analysis. We add the encryption to the laptop, and we add remote wipe capabilities. Then we update the risk register. Remember that giant Excel spreadsheet that had a list of all the risks, and it had all the pertinent information about that specific risk. We implement the countermeasure, the risk is lowered, and the whole point of risk management is to reduce the risk to an acceptable level. What that is, again, depends on senior leadership. Not too much, not too little, exactly right. When we talked about the risk identification and the risk assessment, that was due diligence. Response and mitigation is due care. Here, we act on all the stuff we gathered in the identification and assessment. We implement the countermeasures that senior leadership has chosen, which then brings us to the next phase: risk and control, monitoring and reporting. This, again, is due diligence. This phase's name is a little weird, or at least weirdly worded, but it is because it is both the risk and the control that we implemented that we are monitoring and reporting on. The risk and control, monitoring and reporting is an ongoing process. We keep monitoring the risk, and we keep monitoring the controls that we have put into place to make sure that they are enough. Because new risks emerge all the time, or the risk might just actualize in a way that we did not expect. If you remember back to the KRIs, KPIs, and KGIs, this is where we would actually use the KRIs, key risk indicators, because our threat landscape is never static. We monitor the risks, we monitor the controls, and then we do reporting on them. And of course, that is also ongoing. From this, we make reports that we present to senior leadership in a language that they can understand. As an IT security manager, a CISO, an IT security director, or whatever your job is, this is much of what you are doing. It has been in pretty much any organization that I have worked in. The people at the VP level, the senior leadership group, very often don't have very much understanding of how IT really works, and even less with IT security. That is your job. You need to be that nice translating link that conveys what senior management wants to your staff in a way they understand, and then you need to translate back from the techies to the people who do not understand that, senior leadership. Now back to the monitoring and controlling. Here, we can also use KPIs, the key performance indicators. If we have implemented a single control, we need to know how well is that one control performing, KPI. Because just implementing the controls is never enough. We need to ensure that we have the right controls in place. They are as efficient and as effective as they need to be. So with the KPIs, we'd put numbers on that. And if you are used to working with the waterfall methodology for project management, you know we do one phase, then when that phase is done, we go to the next one. Risk management is not like that. We would, in large organizations, most likely be in all four phases at the same time. Depending on the risk, that would determine which phase we're in. Because new threats emerge all the time, then we go through identification, assessment, response and mitigation, and then monitoring and reporting. In most places where I have worked, we would do an annual risk assessment for everything. But then when we would introduce new environments, we would introduce new servers or new processes, then for those, we would do the risk assessment right there. And then the following year, we would include it in the annual one. With very critical systems, maybe this cycle is not 1 year, it could be 3 months. Every 3 months, we do a full assessment. For the exam, I don't think that granularity is needed, but you need to understand that it is an iterative process. We are never done. And with so many different types of risks, we will be in different phases for different risks at the same time. And with that, we are done with this section. I will see you in the next lecture. If you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up and remember to subscribe to the channel. To get my courses and the free study materials, click on Learn More. Thank you, and I will see you in the next video.